with the topic Introduction to the Novel. This is the novel prescribed for BBA Sem 4 of Mangalore University. Nampally Road by Meena Alexander. Coming to the introduction to the novel. Fiction has been a major tool since many centuries, which articulates the personal trauma, the social crisis, as well as the communal unrest for centuries. It has been used by writers to chronicle their personal experiences, which is later applied to the masses in which the writer lived. In the era of post-colonization and globalization, writers have been incessantly narrating their personal experiences. Meena Alexander, through her novel Nampally Road, chronicles the social and political turmoil in the post-colonial India, where the writer traces the rise of neo-feudalism after the colonial rule. The natives suffer at the hands of political leaders and experiences trauma of political dislocation, issues of identity crisis, and gender in the narrow outlook social cryptograph. The Nampally Road was published in 1991. This fiction is divided into 10 chapters where Meena Alexander describes the crisis of the people of Hyderabad in the immediate post-independence era. The Nampally Road is the landscape in Hyderabad, which is beautifully located at the right address. It's a city with its own descriptive history, both physical and cultural, and also deals about the hierarchies. The present life in the city is reflective of India in the grip of 70s, decade which looks back to the period of India's fraught state of emergency during the rule of Indira Gandhi. The state of emergency in the year 1975 to 1977. This was the critical period where the people went through different crises. Nampally Road is not just a little novel but deliberately chosen road that is tightly packed with the precisely layer upon layer of images, characters, psychological complexities, love and desire, action and violence. Words and images bring the texture of Hyderabad. The architecture under the Nizam rule portrays the today's art form, just like the unfinished red bricks of the Super Bazaar. In the novel, Alexander brings a picture of contemporary India with its multifaceted portrait of Nampally Road, which vividly portrays the restaurant where you find the steaming idlis, the very pungent mouth-watering sambar, the courtyard with the traditional tulsi bush, the fireflies circling it at night, and even the Sagar Talkies, the theater which you find over there in the novel, brings a screening image of a multi-million rupee film on Isaac, or the stationery shop run by Muhammad Ali. The novel is totally based on some incidents which had happened in Hyderabad during the particular time of emergency on the Nampally Road. The novel's vivid and poetic language traces a feast. It brings a feast for the senses and grows more involved with the protests surrounding the brutal incidents which undergoes with the bloodshed, examining what Wordsworth can signify for people terrorized by the state. The book focuses on a young protagonist, Meera Kannadikal, the main character of the novel, who returns from England after having her degree, after her studies, to teach literature and make sense of herself. She is trying to find out her lost self in England, want to find it in India. Her option of joining teaching is to explain the beauty and relevance of Wordsworth. She was the fan of Wordsworth. She wants to teach the beauty of Wordsworth's work to the students. But later, her impact of teaching Wordsworth takes a turn, a serious twist in the novel. Her poetic language of Wordsworth in the classroom becomes her socially sanctioned battlefield against politics. Her undiscussed hidden secrets come out through her poetic lines in her notebook. Her eyes search for others who would fulfill her inner urge of protest against the despotic chief minister and ever-ready goons. This is regarding the introduction to the novel Nampally Road. If you would like to have any further reading, you can go through the text Compulsory Foundation Course in English for the BBA degree program SEM 4. Thank you one and all. Have a good day.